Hello, everybody, and welcome to Inside Georgia Football with head coach Mark Richt. I'm Chuck Dowdle. Great show for you this week as the Dogs go on the road and go into the SEC at a very tough venue. And it's always been a difficult place for the Bulldogs to play as they travel to Columbia, South Carolina to take on the Gamecocks of the old ball coach, Steve Spurrier, at Williams-Brice Stadium. We're going to get you all ready for that. You're going to hear from linebackers Amarlo Herrera and Jordan Jenkins. You'll also hear from tight end Jay Rome. We've got defensive line coach Tracy Rocker all mic'd up. That is a real treat for you a little bit later on. Highlights of the game and, of course, the wrap-up from Coach Mark Richt. That's all straight ahead on Inside Georgia Football with head coach Mark Richt.
Inside Georgia Football with head coach Mark Richt is presented by Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future. Own it. Also brought to you by AT&T, building you a better network.
There are certain times in life when things get crazy. Like when we have great expectations. When it's time to move on. Or when life just happens. And when things change and I need a loan, I head to Georgia's Own Credit Union.
Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future. Own it.
Hi, can I help you?
I'm looking for a phone plan. It has to be a great one, and I don't compromise.
Okay, how about 10 gigs of data to share, unlimited talk and text, and you can choose from 2 to 10 lines.
Wow, sounds like a great deal. So, I'm getting exactly what I want then.
Appears so.
Now, I'm not too sure what to do with my arms right now, because this is where I usually start throwing things.
Oh, that's terrifying.
AT&T's best ever pricing. 2 to 10 lines, 10 gigs of truly shareable data, unlimited talk and text, starting at $130 a month.
Fans use signs to identify themselves. The chop. The fork. The O. Hook 'em horns. But there's one sign everyone wants to be identified with. Number one. Fans show their loyalty in all kinds of ways. Ours, just buy another Hyundai. Number one in customer loyalty 5 years in a row. Show your loyalty using the hashtag ThisIsLoyalty.
Inspire our players.
Georgia has the win over 18th ranked LSU.
I'll try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by AT&T. Building you a better network.
I think it was good for us to get a bunch of practices in, let that other game kind of fade off in the distance, and really get to focus on what's most important. And that's, quite frankly, execution. I think the team that executes the best plays the hardest. Obviously, you know, neither team can just give it away through turnovers and things of that nature, just secure the ball. But I got a feeling this game, you know, it could get a little bloody. You know, I think both teams are tough physically, and I think both teams got outstanding backs that can pound. And I know both teams know how to throw and catch. There's no doubt about that. History has proven that. But before it's over, it may get down to a little bit of a fist fight.
We really had to dig into practice, dig into our film, see what we were kind of shaky on, see what we did wrong, and really come in with the mindset that we have to make ourselves better this week. We can't rely on getting better because we know we have a game this week. We have to have the mental, the mental toughness and to go out here and do it on our own and make ourselves better.
Anytime you're playing a team with a great running back, you just got to make tackles, get off blocks, and play physical that game.
Some of the things that I think we have to focus on coming into the South Carolina game is just we have to get ready for the high-powered running back they got, Mike Davis, in the backfield. He's definitely a hard runner. He runs low to the ground, has great balance, and we really have to get prepared for the huge offensive line. They got some big guys.
We know we're not going to be able to hear most of the game. So instead of just waiting until Thursday before the game and turn the crowd noise on, We just started out right away with a lot of nonverbal cadence, a lot of even as we're signaling things out, we're not allowing the quarterback to call out what it is so everybody can hear it, because they probably aren't going to be able to hear them in the game, so they got to make sure they can get the signals without the help of the quarterback. And even the our snap count has been nonverbal the entire time. And then we'll add some crowd noise probably the last 2 days. But we're basically going through the mechanics of not being able to hear really since early last week.
My biggest advice to the younger guys would be that we have to be focused when we go in there. We can't go in there playing around. We can't go in there not focused. We really have to take account for everything that we need to do, and we really have to go in there with technique in mind. We really have to be really disciplined in our technique, because if you get down when you're on the road and give the other team some life, it's so hard to come back. Like, for example, when we lost to South Carolina 2 years ago, I mean, once we started getting down, they started scoring. Their crowd got going crazy. They started playing that sandstorm. They were jumping around, spinning those towels. You know, their whole family was getting, they were just feeding off of it. So you can't give them anything to feed off of, because once you get down and let their fans start going and they get pumped up, then it's just a landslide after that. So we have to go in there from the very first kickoff focused and ready to play and never let them jump up on us.
Playing on the road in the SEC, a message I give to the young guys is that it's going to be loud. It's going to be hectic. It's going to be one of the most exciting things you'll ever experience, and one of the hardest things to prepare for, because South Carolina is that's a hostile place.
I think they're dangerous because they're a very good team. I think they're dangerous because they're very well coached. I think they're dangerous because they're in their house. And I'm sure they have more confidence at home than they do away. Well, I say they do. They should have confidence at home because they had an 18 game winning streak at home. You know, they've lost one time in 20 games at home. So it's been an advantage for them, and I think they're very comfortable playing there and believe. You know, if you've only lost one game in 20 games at home, you probably got a lot of confidence playing there. So they're dangerous for all those reasons.
Coming up next, a legend on the football field and making a name for himself as a defensive line coach, Tracy Rocker, all mic'd up.
Can I help you?
I'm looking for a phone plan. It has to be a great one, and I don't compromise.
Okay, how about 10 gigs of data to share, unlimited talk and text, and you can choose from 2 to 10 lines.
Wow, sounds like a great deal. So, I'm getting exactly what I want then.
Appears so.
Now, I'm not too sure what to do with my arms right now, because this is where I usually start throwing things.
Oh, that's terrifying.
AT&T's best ever pricing. 2 to 10 lines, 10 gigs of truly shareable data, unlimited talk and text, starting at $130 a month.
Together we're a team, and together we're family. No place gives teams the brands they need at the lowest prices like Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price, every day.
Our 21st birthday is one you don't want to miss, because you could win up to $2.5 million or one of 12 Kia Souls. How's that for party gifts? We're all grown up, and it's your time to celebrate. Play the 21 Black Series Scratchers, new from the Georgia Lottery.
I know they inspire our players.
I try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by Georgia Lottery.
Right foot, let's go. Be fast. We got to have a break. Mike, why you last? Here we go, going to the left.
Whoa.
Come on, get it, Ray. Let's go, Ray. Boy, you out there, you'll tear up a piece of grass. Let's go, Johnny boy. Let's go, hurry. Hurry up, Mike.
I feel like Coach Rocker brings so much and more to our defensive room, and because he wants guys, and he's gonna get it out. He wants guys to go hard, give effort, and he's gonna find a way, whether it takes two or three days or a whole week or a month, he's gonna get you to give that effort. And it's not that he does it in a mean way. He keeps it real with you, and he's not gonna sugarcoat anything. If you're doing good, he's gonna tell you you're doing it good, and if you're doing it bad, he's gonna tell you that you did it bad, and he's gonna tell you how to do it, how to change that, and how to get better.
Hey, right there. No, you fine. Now take your hand. You're on your knees. Just take. I got you. Let go. Oh, now that tells you you need to back up a little. Put your tips there. You see what I'm saying? Your tips there. You got it. Be quick. Squeeze it. That's good. Oh, yeah, we got a chance. Got a chance. How you gonna act while you're away from the house, Mike?
He's a different type of guy. He's serious a lot. He's very serious. And when you step on that field, he wants you to be ready. And there's no playing around when he on that field.
Segu, boom, right there. Get your face up and stop being scary. Segu, boom. You're not looking at him, Ray. Segu. Boom, right there. Nice job, Mont. How far is he gonna jog all the way to the, he gonna make it to this hash, the first hash, or he gonna make it all the way to our second hash? He gonna make it to this near hash. Y'all think he gonna make it? Don't look at it. I don't think he gonna make it. I really don't. What's up, man? He wouldn't stop. Let's go right here, baby. Come on, big guy. Come on. Watch him, big man. Bam, bam. You see him right? You see how he flipping? Don't drift off. Stay tight. You know what I'm saying? Bam. Oh, that's better. Don't drift on me. There we go. Tuck it away, Johnny boy. Make sure we go to the right end zone. That's the biggest concern. Boom, stab it now. Your head in the ground. Boom, stab it, that's better. Play through it, big man. Play through it. Look at here. Boom, right. Look at here. Look at Ray, didn't get cut this time. Boy, I wish you do the drill right.
Coach Rock he's a character. On the field, all business. You know, you don't want to cross him wrong because you know, this is life. That's all he's been doing his entire life. We talked about it the other day in the meeting room as far as, you know, what he would be doing if he wasn't coaching, you know, and still didn't get a clear-cut answer because, you know, it's the only thing he knows.
How y'all keep flying down? Come down here. You stop zipping up onto me like me and you tight. Me and you ain't close. Slide down some more. Right there. Look at your hands. What is that? Well, now, how tall is this dude we playing against? Come on.
He's gonna say something every day, you know, no matter how bad you're feeling, no matter how much you're hurting, he's gonna say something that's gonna make you laugh, and, you know, I like that from him.
Here we go. 18, send you, boom, right there. Why are your hands down here, may I ask, young man? This is how you came off the ball. You came off the ball. This is you. You came off the ball.
Here we go, sit, go.
This way. That's how your hands are came. Why is not thumbs up? What are you trying to do, save them? It's not hot, then it's kind of hot. It's kind of maybe hot, then it's not really hot. What is it? It's just hot? It's hot, the humid, or? I figured all these weathermen would come out all of a sudden. Two, boom, hey, look at him, he's not scared. He's not scared. Hold up, Cat Daddy. We good? Yeah. Payback, huh? I got it. Don't worry, I can set the drill up now. Here we go. You got me, man?
Stay with us when Inside Georgia Football with head coach Mark Richt continues. Highlights of the Dogs and the Gamecocks from Columbia.
There are certain times in life when things get crazy. Like when we have great expectations. When it's time to move on. Or when life just happens. And when things change and I need a loan, I head to Georgia's Own Credit Union.
Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future. Own it.
Last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0!
To Tennessee leading, crowd roaring against Georgia, trying to make them drop it. We hand it off to Herschel. There's a hole. 5, 10.
All I remember is hitting his leg, and it was like I hit a tree trunk. It was the hardest thing I've ever hit.
12, he's running over people. Oh, you Herschel Walker. My God almighty, he ran right through two men. Herschel ran right over two men. They had him dead away inside the 9.
This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future, own it.
Columbia, South Carolina, Williams-Brice Stadium. That's where we are, and we are in a lightning weather delay for Georgia and South Carolina. Neither team really got onto the field to start loosening up. Even the kickers and the other special teams units that usually come out a little extra early never really got going today. So we've had lightning in the area most of this afternoon, and it continues to be that way. Georgia will start from its own 31-yard line, fake to Gurley. Mason going to set up and throw far side. There is McKenzie, open, backpedaling, catches the first ball of the game for Georgia in Carolina territory. Now here's a screen to Sony Michel. Screen is going to take it to the house. Michel with a touchdown. He got beautiful blocking on the far side, and Michel just right down the seam from right to left, easily into the end zone for the score. Two plays, and Georgia is an extra point away from tying it immediately. Ball on the 28 for South Carolina. It's third down, about 7 to go. Pitch it, and the ball is loose. It's on the carpet. Georgia dives on it. Did Georgia get it? The Dogs have it. Dogs have the ball. They pitched it out left, and looked like Lorenzo Carter came out of the pile with it. Far hash, kicking left. Adam Erickson is the holder. He'll spot the ball at the 26. Morgan's kick is away. A 36-yarder is good. That's his 19th in a row, and that is a new SEC record for consecutive field goals. Dogs ball on the Carolina 39. Play fake Gurley. Mason wants to throw. There's Blazevich. Oh, what a catch! Backpedaling. He reached up his right arm, brought it in with one hand. Now Georgia will try a field goal from the right hash, kicking at a bit of an angle for the right-footed kicker, Morgan. It's going to be about a 27-yarder. The hold by Erickson is good, and the kick is away, and it is good. High formation, Taylor Maxey, the fullback, Gurley the tail. Hand off Gurley with blocking and a hole. Left side, 40, 45, 50. There goes Gurley. He needs some downfield blocks. He got another one. Still on his feet at the 30 and down at the 25. First and goal from the Carolina 2. Dogs down by 11, trying to tighten it up a little bit. Man in motion to the near side, Bennett. Hand off Gurley. Straight ahead. Touchdown standing, Todd Gurley.
Boy, exactly what the doctor ordered right there. Todd Gurley running extremely hard.
South Carolina defense jumping into the gaps. Hand off Nick Chubb. Chubb with a gap. Chubb to the 20. Chubb to the 10. Jumps over a tackler and out of bounds on the near sideline. Gurley's the tailback. Hicks is the fullback. Two receivers to the near side. We're going left now. Play fake Mason. He'll throw it. And caught! Touchdown, J. Rome! The big tight end from Valdosta reached up and grabbed it. Third and one for the Dogs from the Carolina 31. Power formation. Handed off to the fullback. Big Hicks. Quavon Hicks is going to break it at the 20, at the 10, near sideline. Out of bounds at the 5. Gurley is back in on third and goal from inside the 1. Hand off to Hicks, though. Hicks stopped initially, tried to get in on second effort, and he does! Touchdown! Two receivers this way as well. Thompson drops back in the pocket, throws it over the middle, and it's picked off! Picked off by the Dogs! Coming this way is Damian Swan. Swan inside the 10, returns it down to the 9. Swan jumped the route, picked it off, took it right out of their hands. Highway robbery, Damian Swan. 3rd and 7, Carolina from their own 43-yard line. 2:06 to go in the ball game, and Georgia trails by 3, 38-35. Our defense creeping up towards the line of scrimmage. They snap it, hand it off to Wilds. He's got a bit of a seam, straight ahead, running to the 50. It's going to be close to a first down. If he got it, that might be a disaster for Georgia. Here's the measurement. They stretch it out. No indication yet. It's that close. Oh, officials say they got it. Well, that was a game of millimeters there. It was less than a game of inches.
Up next, we'll hear from the head coach himself. Mark Richt will talk about the Gamecocks and the Georgia Bulldogs.
From last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
To 2, Tennessee leading, crowd roaring against Georgia, trying to make them drop it. We hand it off to Herschel. There's a hole. 5, 10.
All I remember is sitting his leg, and it was like I hit a tree trunk. It was the hardest thing I've ever hit.
12, he's running over people. Oh, you Herschel Walker. My God almighty, he ran right through 2 men. Herschel ran right over 2 men. They had him dead away inside the 9.
Inspire our players.
Georgia has to win over 18th ranked LSU.
I'll try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
To 2, Tennessee leading, crowd roaring against Georgia, trying to make them drop it. We hand it off to Herschel. There's a hole. 5, 10.
All I remember is sitting his leg, and it was like I hit a tree trunk. It was the hardest thing I've ever hit.
12, he's running over people. Oh, you Herschel Walker. My God almighty, he ran right through 2 men. Herschel ran right over 2 men. They had him dead away inside the 9.
Inside Georgia Football with head coach Mark Richt is presented by Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future. Own it. Also brought to you by AT&T, building you a better network. This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere.
Coach, I want to get to some of the individual performances in this game and ask you about that. But before I do, let me talk to you just about the way this thing started with the delays and having to wait. And I know it was the same for both teams, but what kind of problems does that present for the coaches, for these players? That you're all set to go, everything's so much on a schedule.
Right. Normally you time everything to the minute, including anything you might want to say before you hit the field. Try to get the guys at an emotional peak. That's probably the thing that is the hardest to manage once you get these delays over and over and over again. There's probably 3 times we started to flex inside in the locker room, getting ready to go out. as soon as we get ready to go out, they have another delay, and probably had two or three pregame speeches before we went out the door.
Coach, Todd Gurley again just keeps wowing people. That perhaps one of the most impressive runs he made was when he went left, turned around, reversed his field, got you a key first down. The young man is special.
Well, he's definitely trying to will his way to victory and trying to do everything he could to help his team win. And you know, he's a tough kid, but we had a lot of guys fighting hard for our team to win. For the most part, Hudson made some good decisions and threw the ball pretty good in the rain. You know, no picks, two TDs, did a nice job. I think overall, our line had some positive moments. At the very end, when we got that stop, we needed it the most to give us that chance. We got that pick, set us up to go ahead or tie, and just that was kind of a crushing time of the game for us. We had worked so hard to fight our way back in it, and then we get that big stop, get the big turnover, and get zero out of it. It didn't suck the life out of us, but
you can feel it. I mean, can definitely feel it.
I mean, we could have got one more stop again and had enough time to come in there and get a field goal or a touchdown to win it. But we didn't seize the moment that we had created.